I am a tall tree, oh, I am a swift wind, swift in the country. I am a river, down in the valley, oh, I am a vision, and I can see clearly.
I would also like to thank all of my teachers, Ms. Andrews, Ms. Acock, Ms. Wells, and the wonderful substitutes for Mrs. Apcott after she had her baby. Because without our teachers, we would go nowhere in life, especially without an elementary school education. Everything I've been through at West Oxford has been a wonderful experience, like every field trip, such as the overnight field trip to the beach, every learning experience, and even going to the playground with all of my friends by my side. Out of every school that I will go to, I will always remember West Oxford because it is very special, even though it's a school where you learn things which you think would be boring. But this school has made learning really fun. If there are any kids that are about to start fifth grade, or any grade for that matter, don't be worried about too much because you can do anything if you put your mind to it. Thanks for giving me the opportunity to give a speech.
Good morning, teachers, students, and staff. I would like to welcome all of you to the fifth grade completion ceremony, a day where we all celebrate after a whole year of hard work and effort. I would like to say well done to all students who have worked hard throughout this whole year. In my opinion, this day is more like a sad day because I will be leaving West Oxford and my teachers who helped me improve in every subject. I want to say thank you to every teacher who have taught me valuable things in my life that I cannot forget. That includes all fifth grade teachers and special teachers. I also want to give a special thanks to both my parents and my grandpa who stood beside me all the time and encouraged me and helped me accomplish my dreams. Thank you very much, West Oxford, and bye.
We have all done a great job doing and trying our best. It was a pleasure meeting you guys and getting the opportunity to know you. But now we are off to graduate and to start a new chapter in life. Fifth grade was one of the best grades knowing that we are going off to a different school and getting to be more mature. One of the best memories I will always remember is making new friends and knowing that they will always be there for me. I will also remember the saying that I sometimes say to my best friend. A friend is like a four-leaf clover, rare to find and hard to keep. I have learned so many lessons from being here at West Oxford. For example, the golden rule, treat others the way you want to be treated. This rule has gotten me through a lot of situations. I remember the first day of school, we were learning how to write sentences, and now we are at the end of elementary school graduating. I have always loved Dr. Steve since I was in kindergarten, so when I found the quote, you have brains in your head, you have shoes in your feet, and you are so kind, you are human shoes, but Dr. Steve, it meant a lot to me. They told me that I should choose my path and let nobody influence me differently. I also remember thinking more than now. It meant that I'm successful and that I can achieve anything in life. We should all be proud of what we achieve in life. Try your best and do your best. Always remember that the stars are the limit. We should also be proud of everyone who's graduating and off to middle school. My mom always says it doesn't matter if you win or lose. Everybody is a winner if you try your hardest and you're happy. This inspired me because it's been to never give up. Another person who inspires me is my dad. He always says to do it, not because someone makes you, but because you want to or for your own good. Just like the doctor's use quote, this is to choose your own path and don't let others choose for you. Thank you for taking the time to listen to my speech.
To the class of 2017. I stand here before you today with high expectations of our future as we depart from this place. Let us carry forth the memories of when we first entered this building. I remember as a kindergartner, I was nervous entering a big school, afraid that I'd get lost and not be able to find my way around. My teacher, Ms. Archer, assured me that everything was going to be okay and that she'd be there for guidance. Through the rest of my years here at West Oxford, not only did I find my way, but I was also able to give guidance to the students beneath me. As your fellow fifth grade honoree, I would like to thank each and every teacher as well as my parents and family members who helped me make this all possible. Now as we enter into this new chapter in our lives, let us remember that we will be taking a stand once again into a new building in which we call school. Some of us are more nervous than others, but let us remember all the stuff that we have been taught. Being respectful to each other as well as to others Remember to smile and not to let anyone put you down, because we are somebody. Lastly, to always be that guidance that you once needed, to be that to someone else in hopes that one day that person can be standing in this very place that I am in, giving this very same speech, if not better. And in closing, I'd like to say to you, my fellow classmates, we made it this far, and let our journey in life continue on. To our teachers, we thank you for all your hard work and putting up with each other and every one of us, and for giving us proper tools necessary to continue our journey. And to our parents, we love you, and we would like to say, we finally made it. This is now a new chapter in our lives, so let the journey begin.